Hey guys, it's your girl Secret D with yesterday's strawberry letter response. So as I explained in the last letter, I really was checking for it this week, right? So either way, here we go. What's the title? Hold on. All right, the title of the letter is His Father Has to Keep It Down. This lady writes in, she said that she's married to a man who can't say no to his family. She said that they met, I forgot how many years ago, but they met some time ago when they were younger in his father's shoe shop, and they dated, fell in love, and ended up getting married. She said that his father came through when she was in college because her family came on some hard times, and his father paid for her last year of college. She said for that, she'll be forever grateful, and he'll be one of her favorite people. She said her father did eventually pay him back in installments, so that's all set. Now, fast forward. She said the father is 72 years old. He's on his second marriage, and he cheated on his wife in March. I'm using her dates because I'm assuming the letter is recent. In March, he got caught. He said he was relieved so that he can leave. So he asked if he could stay with them, and she said she told him no, go figure out stuff with your wife. And her husband overruled her and told him yes, he can stay. He also told her that, like, well, reminded her that his father helped her out all those years ago, so she owes him, or they owe him, or whatever it was. But that's that. But so she described their house as basically like a duplex. She said when you open the door, you go upstairs, and that's the main home. And when you go downstairs, there's a bonus room, a sauna, and a bathroom. So the father lives downstairs. She said now he has a girlfriend, Miss Beverly, and they be making all kinds of noise because they be doing the nasty. And she hears them at all hours. She's caught them down there having sex. Multiple times on the pull-out sofa. She's caught them naked in her sauna that her husband bought her for Christmas. And now she's just like... So, she said she hears them all the time, all hours of the night, because there's no door closing off that part of the house. And she's basically had enough. So, she wants to know how she can tell her papa, she calls him, which is her husband's father, who's 72, that him and his girlfriend got to go. Alright, listen. 72, your man is getting it on. He's living his best life. Now, I don't agree. I don't know if he's working. It doesn't seem like he's working because all she's talking about is fucking. So, I don't know if my man got a job or what, but it seems like he needs to do something to get out, right? So he's been there, she said, March, they broke up. We're going to say like 6 months. So it hasn't even been that long, but it's been a while. But I feel like I would feel some type of way too. I don't know if they have kids. She never said. So I'm going to assume they don't. So I don't get it. If she can hear them having sex, then her husband can also hear them having sex. And I don't know how he's okay with that. That's a little weird. I don't want to hear some lady begging and pleading while my father is smashing. Like, that's disturbing, okay? Either way, I don't know. It's hard because she's the one who told the man he couldn't stay. Her husband was like, you lying because he's staying type thing. So it's basically like you against him, and your husband clearly does not respect your wishes because he told his father, like, nah, ignore her, you can stay. So I don't think your father-in-law is leaving anytime soon because his son doesn't want him to leave. So, I mean, yeah, you're the one with the problem. And when you didn't want him to come in the first place, your husband said, no, he's coming. And then he came. So when you're ready for him to leave, it doesn't seem like your husband has a problem with it. So he's not leaving. I hate to say it, but I don't know what you're going to do, sis. You're going to have a real serious conversation with your husband and let him know how you feel. Because you're not able to use your little sauna you got for Christmas. and all this good stuff, which is, you know, it's an imposition. I feel like his father is being inconsiderate. I feel like he's not considering your feelings in this. I don't think he's considering anybody but himself. And I feel like it's hella selfish. So he's grown. He's a grown man. He can live on his own, it seems that he has the means. It seems like he did well for himself, so I'm assuming he has money. You know, so I personally think that you need to have a serious talk with your husband, even though, like I said, it might not help because he basically overrules you anyway. So I don't know, y'all, what y'all think? Y'all can let me know how y'all feel about it, but that's what I gotta say.